Welcome to the first Jagged Edge Show this year. I'm Haley Ford and
I'm Gwyneth Davidson.
Starting out the school year, we thought we would remind you about what it's really like being a student at Blue Valley West.
Let's take a look at the true pride of the Jaguars.
One school. Four cornerstones. We are excellence. We are pride. We are family. We are grit. We are Blue Valley West.
Wow, we really do have school spirit, don't we?
One other way people are getting involved at Blue Valley West is through theater, more specifically, improv club.
From band, choir, orchestra to debate, the improv troupe is one of a kind at Blue Valley West. It takes a lot of work to run and maintain the troupe.
It means I run rehearsals, run the troupe, I get to decide who gets in the troupe and that sort of thing. Like, we're always, like, rehearsals are just us playing different improv games, trying new things out, and I think we're very laid back. You know, if something goes wrong, we aren't, like, obsessing about it. We're laughing it off.
Improv troupe is a relaxing good time where people are together and they are all having fun.
A unique experience. There's nothing else that you can do at West. It's really quite like it. I think that we can create a lot of unique comedic moments, and we're all really fun people to be around.
Improv is kind of like a nice segue into the theater life. It's just really fun, and the people are really nice.
Improv is something easy. It's something you can get into. It doesn't take a lot of skill, and even if you feel like you're missing something, you can learn really quickly, and it's a lot of fun.
The improv troupe hosts open rehearsals on the first Thursday of every month in the small theater. For updates, you can catch up with them on the Blue Valley West Theater's Twitter. Signing off for Jagged Edge TV, this is Amina Syed.
If you want more information about the club, they meet Thursdays during B session of JAG, and open rehearsals for everyone to watch is the first Thursday of every month.
Hey Gwen, what other clubs are going on during JAG?
I'm not sure, but Anthony and Leah took a further look at a newly trending club.
Coach Hintz's room is a place for all students to get together and do a bunch of fun activities. We took a look at what some students had to say about Coach Hintz's room.
I like to come to Coach Hintz's room because there's so many things to do here. I can do a puzzle, I can play basketball, I can always do some homework, and I can play chess if I want to.
Coach Hintz's room provides a quiet environment so that students can get their work done during JAG Session B. This room is not just limited to this group of kids.
Everybody is welcome here. We have a great variety of kids. Everybody loves this place. Come on down to Coach Hintz's room.
For JETV, this is Leah Brokaw and Anthony Savignano.
Don't forget, room number 323.
I just realized how many new restaurants are coming up in the Johnson County area.
I know, I love the one we went to yesterday. Let's do a recap.
Have you ever been in the situation where you can't decide between having sushi or burritos? Well, JETV found the perfect restaurant for you. Welcome to Comatoto. This is Nika. She's the owner and manager of Comatoto, located on 135th and Metcalf.
It is a sushi burrito based restaurant. We make oversized sushi rolls and we also have poke bowls. Our poke bowls are very unique, as well as our avocado fries. There's only a couple places in Kansas City that offer avocado fries, and our homemade sauces are amazing. Everything, almost everything on our menu is handcrafted, and so we're able to create and customize a lot of our product.
Comitoto wasn't the first restaurant to turn sushi into burritos. Creator Alonzo Martinez was inspired by the concept after visiting a restaurant in Singapore and decided to bring the sushi burrito to the States.
We visited Denver, came across the Comitoto in Denver, and fell in love with the concept, and we wanted to be the first ones to bring it to Kansas City.
So, Nika, how do you properly eat a sushi burrito?
So you want to hold it like a hot dog. I wish I had one. But you want to hold it like a hot dog, and you have to hold the bottom the whole time so that nothing falls out. And then you unwrap it as you go. So as long as you hold it at an angle, just like a hot dog, you'll be completely fine. Otherwise, it'll just fall apart on you, but the experience is amazing. It's more of an experience than just food, you know, and it's like art.
Over the last few weeks, they've been getting some great publicity.
Do you know who else is getting some great publicity that I just saw on Fox 4 News?
What's that?
Miss Harris and Moxie were talking about Moxie's mission a few days back.
I know that lots of people know Miss Harris, but let's take a look at some more information Jolie got about her.
This is Miss Harris, a Blue Valley West social worker, and this is her dog, Moxie. Miss Harris got Moxie just over a year ago, where she was trained by the American Service Dog Association to help Miss Harris with a variety of different tasks and activities.
So Moxie does several different things. One of the most important ones that she was doing for me was she was doing medical alert. So if I was going to have a seizure, she was learning how to alert me before I was going to have the seizure or with my blood pressure.
Another task that Moxie helps Miss Harris with is picking up many different items. Moxie can get water bottles, pick up her phone, pick up her keys, and even open and close some doors.
So Moxie's mission was something that came out of my struggle. Any time that I'm really feeling down or I'm not doing well, helping other people ultimately makes you feel better. So I decided, I wonder if I can raise enough money to fully fund a fully trained service dog to just gift to an individual in need.
To achieve this goal, the event will need to raise over $15,000.
Stop thinking about things that I can't do, and I need to start focusing on something that I can do. And the quote by Booker T. Washington, "To lift yourself up, lift somebody else up," really just stuck to my mind.
At the event, there will be a six-legged relay race, an auction, a costume contest, and more. Moxie's mission is on October 20th, down by the River Market by Port KC. You will need four people, yourself, and a dog. It's $25 per person, plus $5 if you are interested in joining the costume contest. To be a part of Moxie's mission, go to runsignup.com/Moxie's mission. Make sure to follow Moxie and Miss Harris on all social medias to keep up with the latest Moxie adventures. Join Miss Harris and Moxie on October 20th to help make a difference. For JETV, this is Jolie Brown.
Having a service dog is a big responsibility on both parts, but another person who has to have great responsibility are police officers, keeping us all safe.
Not only are they protecting all of us, but they're educating students along the way about self-defense and what it's like being an officer.
I know Mock had a great time at the Explorer program meeting. He can tell us more about it.
The Kansas City Advisor Program is a nationwide club sponsored by the Boy Scouts of America.
We're hoping to get kids into the program, and obviously one of our goals is to eventually recruit from these pool of kids. But it's also to get kids engaged in the community, to see what law enforcement's like, to see if it's something that they're interested in the future. So several different things.
The program has been running for over 12 years now in Overland Park and experienced great success, with many kids going on to become supervisors and sergeants.
A lot of good kids come to our program. They learn a lot of things. They have a good time. But they also get a really good view of what we do and understanding of what we do and why we do the things that we do.
Over time, students get to learn radio procedures and phonetic alphabets, amongst other fun activities.
We'll get into taser. Everybody likes that because that's a fun topic. And we'll also do our less lethal shotgun beanbag rounds, so kids will get to fire those. We'll also have firearm simulators where we put you in a scenario in front of a video screen with some training guns and put people in quote-unquote real-life situations as far as they can be simulator. So at the end of June, obviously everybody's out of school. We do a week-long, it's like a day camp, Monday through Friday. We'll go through different topics. My most memorable thing is when we go out to the Timber Ridge Activity Center and we do their challenge course out there. So the kids get a chance to do some team building stuff, and it's always fun to watch the kids tackle the climbing tower. So that's a good time. Seeing people who didn't think that they could do it, you know, really take the initiative to get it done, jump up there and climb to the top of that tower. So it's really cool seeing kids accomplish something that they didn't think that they could. And that's some of my most memorable stuff every year. So
for more information, visit opkansas.org or email Officer Faber with any questions you have.
Wow, so many exciting things are happening around us right now.
I know, we just had homecoming just a few weeks back.
I had so much fun at the dance and the carnival.
This was my last homecoming. I just want to go back and do it all over again.
I'm sorry, I can't help you out with that one. But Kelsey can help you relive all of those moments.
Well, let's see that right now.
The homecoming dance was only a fraction of the excitement at Blue Valley West a few weeks ago. If you missed out on the preparation, here's what went down before the first dance of the year. This is how the Jags do homecoming.
Sure has been a great start to the school year, hasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Even through power outages and Canvas glitches, Jags power through.
We are so lucky to be part of the Blue Valley West family.
Thanks everyone for the best start of the school year.
See you next time.
Have a great day, Jags!